Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So today we are going to look into chapter 3, which is electrochemistry. Okay, so jom kita start. So dalam chapter galvanic, dalam chapter electrochemistry, we are going to look into galvanic cell, which will cover cell diagram, cell notation, as well as what else? E not cell, and then kita ada E cell. Ah, tu je lah kot. Oh, ada lagi. Next equation. Right. The differences between galvanic cell and electrolytic cell. You can look this info in your lecture notes, slide number 6. So, I am going to put it here just in case. Nanti saya tak go through lah. Belum baca sendiri. Next, kita juga akan cover redox reaction. So again, I will not cover this explanation, but you can refer this in your lecture notes, slide number 7. Okay, so ini kita punya dalam nota awak lah. Okay, so how do we determine which one is anode and which one is cathode? Right, so for example, let's say saya nak guna Al3 plus dengan iron. So, awak ada dua half cell yang diberi. The first one is Al3 plus slash Al sebelum bentuk reduction. E naught is negative 1.66 volt. The second one is iron 2 plus become iron. The E naught is negative 0.44 volt. So which of these two half cell will become anode and cathode? So how do we determine? Okay. So the answer is we look at the E naught value. The more positive E naught value will become cathode, and the more negative E naught value will become anode. So the value must be in reduction form. So RED is referring to reduction. By reduction meaning you akan tengok dia punya charges dia makin lama makin berkurang. Yang atas tu Al3 plus jadi Al solid. 3 plus become kosong. 2 plus, 2 plus become kosong. So based on this value, negative 1.66 is more negative than 0.4. So that's why Al tu akan jadi and Fe2 plus will become cathode. Okay, proceed. So next part is how does ataupun where does this value E not comes from? So ini kita akan ambil daripada SRT list, which stands for Standard Reduction Potential. So saya akan letak dia punya gambar rajah SRT list, contoh kat sini. Ini saya Google je, ataupun boleh Google sendiri. Okay, next one we have, so the diagram for galvanic cell. So yang ni nak melukis lah. Saya akan guna Al3 plus dengan iron tadi yang kita dah guna contoh tu. So dalam video ni saya akan guna Al3 plus dengan iron 2 plus most of the time, kebanyakannya lah. So kita dah tentukan N dengan cathode tadi. So, kita start dengan kita punya half equation. Anode kita ada Al solid become Al3 plus equals plus 3 electron equation. And then kita punya cathode daripada Fe2 plus equals plus 2 electron to become Fe solid. So kenapa dia oxidation process daripada 0 jadi plus 3. So anode oxidation. Cathode plus 2 become 0. So itu adalah reduction process. Okay, so ini kita ada dua beaker, two separate beaker. So kita letakkan kita punya electrode dalam bentuk solid. Mesti solid sebab kita nak kepitkan dia with our crocodile clip wire tu. Okay, so kita tuang kita punya electrode. Make sure you punya electrolyte electrolyte dengan electrode mesti benda yang sama lah. Okay, then kita connectkan to half cell with our short bridge. Contoh short bridge is KCL, and then kita letak wire, ada wattmeter, then start label. First label adalah anode cathode. Yang seterusnya, okay, solid, Al solid, electrolyte mesti Al juga. Di plus aqueous ataupun Al nitrate ke, bergantung lah. And then electrode Fe solid, and then kita ada Fe2 plus aqueous. Standard condition 1 molar for both. Okay, and then kita akan letak kita punya the movement of electron from anode pergi ke cathode. Okay, so apa jadi pada kita punya electrode? So Al electrode will become thinner, sebab Al solid dia bertukar jadi Al3+. So concentration Al3+ will increase dalam nikel tu lah. Okay, dekat cathode pula, so Fe electrode will become thicker, sebabnya Fe2+ dia dah terima 2 elektron menjadi Fe solid. So, Fe solid tu, so akan jadi tebal, concentration Fe2+ akan berkurang. So what is the function of salt bridge in this cell? So kita ada dua function, nak detail tengok nota. Ringkasnya, the first one is to maintain electrical neutrality, and the second one is obviously to complete the circuit. Cabut litar, cabut litar lah, cabut salt bridge, litar tak lengkap, tak adalah dapat hasil. Okay, so for full explanation you can refer to your lecture note, atau kalau awak malas tanya lagi punya pensyarah pun kalau dia rajin explain. Okay, next. So how to write the overall cell reaction? So yang dia penting sebenarnya adalah overall. Kita akan guna overall untuk cell notation. The first part is we need to start with two half equation ataupun two half cell reaction. And then we need to balance the number of electron for both equation. And the last one, we must cancel out that electron. Electron tak mungkin wujud dalam overall reaction. Okay, so kita guna yang tadi, anode Al solid become Al3 plus aqueous and 3 electron. Okay, saya nak abaikanlah nilai inert tu. And then for cathode, we have Fe2 plus aqueous plus 2 electron become Fe solid. Okay, so make sure kita punya electron tu balance. So yang atas equation akan darab dengan 3, the bottom one will multiply with 3. So that will be 2 Al solid, 2 Al dengan 6 electron. And then 3 Fe, 6 electron, 3 Fe jugalah. Okay, so buat satu garisan. We cancel out the electron, so the remaining will be 2 Al solid plus 3 iron 2 plus aqueous produce 2 Al 3 plus aqueous and 3 iron solid. Okay, so yang hitam bawah tu kita panggil dia sebagai overall cell reaction. Okay, next. So E cell ataupun E not cell. E not cell is referring to standard cell potential yang bulat tu. So the word standard is referring to temperature mesti 25 degree Celsius, pressure mesti 1 atm, molarity mesti 1 molar. Tiga benda ni kena follow lah. So dia ada dua cara, two methods to calculate E not cell. Okay, the common one is E not cell equal to E not cathode minus E not anode. And second one is E not cell is equal to E not reduction plus E not oxidation. Okay, both basically pretty much similar. Okay, again we are using the same example as previous, which is Al and iron. Okay, so kita tulis balik yang tadi tu. So untuk method yang pertama, Al3 plus slash Al solid, dia punya nilai E not is negative 1.66 volt. And then for iron 2 plus become iron negative 0.44. Untuk method ini, make sure you punya half cell tu dalam bentuk reduction. 3 plus jadi kosong, 2 plus become kosong. Okay, so this is the chemical formula. Okay, cathode tolak anode. Gantikan nilai negative 0.44 minus negative 1.66 to produce positive 1.22 volt. The sign positive kena ada. Jangan tinggal benda tu. Because the positive sign is referring to spontaneous reaction. Negative, non-spontaneous. Alright, for method number 2. Okay, so untuk method tu awak kena buat dia punya chemical equation dulu. So anode kita ada Al solid become Al3 plus and 3 electron. So bila awak dah reverse kan equation daripada yang sebelum ni, okay, reverse equation, the sign for anode also reverse. Okay, macam chapter thermochemistry, Hess's law yang kita buat tu. Okay. And then cathode. So cathode Fe2 plus to produce Fe solid. Yang ni sama macam asal. So anode dia adalah negative 0.44. Tak perlu nak reversekan. Balancekan elektron, cancel out apa yang perlu. So 2 Al dengan 6 elektron, 3 Fe with 6 elektron. Salin balik. So that is our overall reaction. And the anode is just add up the anode value for both. So positive 1.66 plus negative 1.44. Again, you will get positive 1.22. Next is about oxidizing and reducing agent. Okay, so let's consider one chemical reaction. Ni reaction eh. One whole reaction. Ataupun overall reaction. So 2Ce4 plus aqueous plus CO solid to produce 2Ce3 plus aqueous and CO2 plus aqueous. Right? So Ce4 plus become Ce3 plus. Nombor dia berkurang. Kalau nombor dia, charge dia berkurang. So that is reduction process. Cobalt from 0 become 2 plus. So that is oxidation. So in this reaction, cobalt cause Ce4 plus to reduce to Ce3 plus. Dia kurang macam tu. So CO is reducing agent. Sebab dia menyebabkan Ce4 plus tu kena reduce. Ce4 plus pula, dia causing that cobalt solid to oxidize become cobalt 2 plus. So dia yang menyebabkan CO tu kena oxidize. So Ce4 plus we call as an oxidizing agent. Oh, buat E pula. N tu. English. Okay. So, if you look at this equation, CO and Ce4 plus both are reactant. Meaning, dalam chemical reaction, agent must be on reactant side. Sentiasa pada side reactant. Tak mungkin pada sebelah produk. Okay. And then, kalau kita nak compare the strength, which of these species is stronger oxidizing ataupun stronger reducing agent. Contoh saya guna bromine liquid plus 2 electron to become 2 bromine aqueous. The inert value is positive 1.07 volt. You need tinggal kat situ. SN4 plus aqueous plus 2 electron to become SN2 plus aqueous. The value is positive 0.13 volt. So yang depan ni, belah depan ni kita panggil dia sebagai oxidizing agent. So yang lebih positif will be better oxidizing agent. Apa yang positif tu? Okay. More positive E0 value will be better oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent will undergo process reduction. Dia yang akan kena reduce nanti dia punya charge. Okay. Pada belah produk pula, okay, belah produk dia adalah reducing agent. So the more negative anode value will be better reducing agent. Again, reducing agent will undergo oxidation process. Okay, agent dia mesti kena buat juga dia proses. So just now I mentioned agent dia mesti pada sebelah reactant. It cannot be on the product side. However, tadi saya mention, saya tulis kat atas tu, untuk reducing agent pada sebelah produk. Kenapa? So yang ni yang kita nak, bukan saya nak jelaskan lebih sikit lah. Okay. Yang dua equation atas ni, okay, dua ini adalah two half fraction. Dua half fractions, bukan je whole. Yang tak boleh pada sebelah produk tu, mesti pada reactant saja. It must be overall cell reaction, bukannya half equation. Okay, jelas kat situ? Tak jelas, repeat lagi sekali. Okay, settle part ni. Okay, jom kita masuk seterusnya. If pada, so what if the E not cell become E cell? Kita buang titik atas tu, bulat, whatever lah tu. So itu bermaksud the some of the value taken are not at standard condition. Mungkin temperature bukan 25, suhu sama lah tu. Concentration bukan 1 macam ni, dia bagi 0.01 molar. Pressure bukannya 1 atm. So benda tu akan menyebabkan dia akan jadi E cell. So nilai AL plus tu bukan pada standard. Fe 1 molar itu standard. So, saya tip kat situ. So untuk ini kita kena guna Nernst equation. Right. So this equation is E cell equal to E not cell minus RT over NF ln concentration of product power of X divided by concentration of reactant power of Y. Okay. So R temperature constant 8.314, temperature must be in Kelvin, N refer to mole of electron, and F is our Faraday constant. Itu diberilah dalam soalan. Okay. So if we are using the same example as before, AL and FE, so nilai E naught dia 1.66, and then concentration 0.01 molar for AL, 1.04 ion. So E cell equal to 1.22. Kita dah kira sebelum ni. R 8.314, temperature 298. Kenapa dia 298? Sebab soalan tak mention. Saya yang lupa nak mention. So take assume dia punya suhu 25 degree Celsius. So buat tulis tu, assume temperature is 25. N tu adalah mole of electron used in our chemical reaction. Kan tadi kita potong 6 sini, 6 kanan, 6 kiri. Ha, so 6 je kita potong, bukan 12. Ln concentration of Al3 plus power of 2 divided by concentration iron power of 3. So 2 dengan 3 tu adalah you punya stoichiometry ratio dalam chemical equation overall punya. Okay. So masukkan nilai dan kita akan dapat jawapan lebih kurang positif 1.25 volt. Lebih kurang lah. So if the reaction occurs at equilibrium, ataupun dia suruh cari equilibrium, normally soalan ni awak kena cari equilibrium constant K. Okay, so saya tulis balik Nernst equation. Apa yang berubah pada Nernst equation is ada there are two changes if the reaction is at equilibrium. And the first one is the E cell, the value E cell become zero. Second one, product over reactant will become K. K is our equilibrium constant. Masih lagi ln. Okay, so is E not cell equal to RT over NF ln K. Dan carilah K awak. Okay. So ini khas untuk 25 degree Celsius sahaja. So if the reaction occurs at 25 degree Celsius, the next equation can also be written as okay, E cell equal to E not cell, ni tak tukar, okay, minus 0.0592 over N ln, sorry, log concentration product divided by concentration of reactant. Ni macam tulisan KCKP lah yang tu sebenarnya. Okay, so last part kita akan belajar dari segi cell notation. So dalam cell notation kita akan cover cara penulisan lah. So the first rule is ABC. Second rule ada satu slash, that's mean phase boundary. Double slash refer to salt bridge. Okay, kita ambil balik contoh yang kita dah buat tadi. Kita ada 2 Al solid, plus 3 Fe 2 plus aqueous to become 2 Al 3 plus aqueous and 3 Fe solid. So kita start with the first rule ABC. A refer to anode, C refer to cathode, B is referring to salt bridge. Okay, so A, B, C lah. So A Al solid become Al 3 plus aqueous, triple A double slash salt bridge, Fe 2 plus aqueous become Fe solid. Return dulu baru product. Okay. Somehow if the question give you the concentration of ion and the pressure of a gas, so those info must be included in our cell notation. Okay. So for example, I'm going to use zinc 2 plus aqueous 1 molar slash zinc solid. Kata tak ada face symbol pun dalam ni, tak apalah. So H plus 1 molar, dia akan jadi hydrogen. Okay, padam tu. Dengan unit dia 1 atm. So let's say dia bagi awak concentration dengan pressure. Okay, this is the inert, hydrogen mesti kosong. Hydrogen special. Zinc negative 0.76. So zinc to anode, hydrogen sky cathode. Okay, so our half equation, zinc solid become zinc 2 plus aqueous plus 2 electron. Untuk kita punya cathode, 2H plus aqueous plus 2 electron become hydrogen gas. Okay, and then ini cancel terbiasa lah. Okay. Untuk cell notation, okay, cell notation, kita tak masukkan stoichiometry ya. So kita sekarang zinc solid become zinc 2 plus aqueous, 1 molar. Double slash salt bridge, H plus aqueous 1 molar, hydrogen gas 1 atm slash platinum. Okay, muncul pula platinum kat ujung tu, kenapa? Okay, sebabnya H plus and hydrogen gas tak boleh jadi elektrod. Sebab elektrod mesti kena clipkan dengan crocodile wire tu. Tadi kita nak clip dengan air atau nak clipkan dengan gas. So kita perlukan satu inert electrode. So for example, kita guna kat sini platinum. Right. Next. So untuk last, ni lah contoh. Okay, kalau kita ada dua half equation seperti yang diberi dalam kita punya video ni. Okay, for example, kita punya anode, kita guna magnesium solid to become magnesium 2 plus aqueous plus 2 electron. Ini tak ada masalah. The second one, cathode, Sn 4 plus aqueous plus 2 electron become Sn 2 plus aqueous. So masalahnya adalah kedua-duanya aqueous. Okay, so for cell notation, anode okay, magnesium solid slash magnesium 2 plus aqueous. Kalau ada nilai concentration letak, double slash salt bridge, Sn 4 plus aqueous, sini kena koma, Sn 2 plus aqueous. Okay, tambah lagi satu garis, platinum. Sebabnya, again, pada kita punya cathode, dia kedua-duanya liquid. Okay. And then, disebabkan kedua-duanya adalah phase yang sama, that's why kita buat koma sahaja. Sebab dia are no phase boundary.